I'm sorry, just one second. Everybody, just make sure they muted their phones when we get started. They'll need that on the recording if we can help you. Thank you very much.
I'm glad he said y'all don't come out to be entertained necessarily.
That took a lot of pressure off, didn't it?
Yeah. We're going to treat this just like a practice, so.
This song we're going to do for you first is a song that I had written a while back. Just that very thing that Bob was talking about. Sometimes you get to the point where you just don't want to think about everything that's going on. And this is one of those songs that just sort of spits it out there. I just don't want to think anymore.
Okay. I don't want to talk.
changing that one to emails because nobody really sends letters anymore. I don't think. But we're a little old fashioned when it comes to that. This next song we'll do for you is one we all collectively wrote together, made it up right out of our own heads. It's called Look at Me. And it's a love ballad.
I'll tell you.
We are that kind of guys.
A little story, a little history behind this song that I recall when it was written. We were working on a project, I think, for CMH Records, and I was in the studio room there, working a project, mixing a project. And these three guys went in the back room, and they came out about 30 minutes later with this song. And I thought, wow, you know, what a great song! And I wish I could have been part of it. But it's Look at Me.
Dress nicer, so she picked out these clothes.
may unbutton his vest here in a few minutes.
I think she said you need to dress better, you need to act nicer.
That ain't gonna happen.
No. This next song we'll do for you is one that that we had written. That came from the thought of a railroad perspective. And Andy come up with a really nice riff on the banjo. And we thought, well, we've got to do something with that. We need to put words with that riff. And so we came up with this. It's called Daddy's Life. Studio, and a guy sort of pitched us this song, a guy named Steve Backus, kind of studio we were working in at the time, and he said, here's a great song, you guys should do this. And so he started playing it, and then we got, oh yeah, that sounds great. So he actually played us a demo cut of it, and we thought, yeah, we got to do this. It was such a great song. It has all the trappings of death and despair and civil war and everything a good bluegrass song would want to have. This song has
the perfect bluegrass song.
Yeah, there's killing involved and angry feelings. This is called Old Elijah. It has really great meaning. Don't harbor ill feelings too long. They can come back to haunt you. But this is called Old Elijah. Being an American Joe, just an average guy out here doing his thing. So we titled it American Joe. And so we call it American Joe.
American Andy wouldn't fit.
It didn't roll off the tongue.
Yeah, it was hard to make words that would rhyme
with Andy.
So here's American Joe. Here's American Joe. Thing, right?
darn busy. We can't listen much.
Here's another song that Tony wrote, I don't know how many years ago, but he read it several years before we ever recorded it. But it's a great song, has a great message. Is it on Horse and Pen?
It's on Riding Out the Storm.
On Riding Out the Storm. It's our first CD that we recorded. It's a lot of airplay on one of the radio stations over there, so we're happy for that. We hope you like this song. Listen to the message. We think it'll inspire you.
Thank you.
song off of our Horse and Pen. We have about 18 projects out. That's what you call them these days. They're not albums. They're projects. So we got about 18 of those things out. And one of them is called Horse and Pen. My brother did the artwork for the cover of it, and it's a horse sitting in a rocking chair smoking a pipe, writing songs. So that song went on there. It's gone pretty good. I think there's a YouTube video out there on it. But anyway, we're going to get Andy to play his dobro here a little bit. Or his resonator guitar, whichever you prefer. A song that we got these lyrics from a guy named Leroy Drum. And it was one of the easiest songs to put a melody to. It was just lyrics on page. And we put this melody to it, and it just turned out to be a beautiful song. It's called Shine Jerusalem.
Well, I walked 10 miles on a 12-mile road. Shine, Jerusalem, shine. But the angels are singing and they sound so sweet. Shine, Jerusalem, shine. Oh, and carved my marker from a block of stone. Just say, oh, Jason, when he's done gone home. Shine, Jerusalem, shine. Whoa, shine, Jerusalem, shine. Yes, I'm going to heaven most of your time. Oh, shine, Jerusalem, shine. Blisters are burning on my tired feet. Shine, Jerusalem, shine. But the angels are singing and they sound so sweet. Shine, Jerusalem, shine. Go and carve my marker from a block of stone. Just say, oh, Jason, well, he's done gone home. Shine, Jerusalem, shine.
This is Mr. Andy Richardson over here on the banjo. Over here next to me with the guitar, this is Mr. Vance Henry. And to my right, with the big giant fiddle, is Mr. Ricky Rogers.
Okay, mandolin, singing. Tony Robertson.
Woo!
next song we'll do for you is an instrumental that I wrote a lot of years ago. And it's real funny how this thing came about. It just sort of comes out of the air the way music does most of the time. But it ended up being a sort of an aggressive bluegrass tune, I guess you could say. And I went to a festival one day after we released this on one of our projects. And there were some young guys playing it out under a tree. And there's nothing more humbling than to hear somebody else do something that you've composed. But a few years ago, there was a Hootenanny record came out, or a project came out in England, and a guy called me, sent me an email, actually, and he said, "Hey, can I use this song to go on this project?" And I said, "Yeah, you know, what is it?" You know, and he said it was a Hootenanny project, and I thought, "Wow, what an odd place for a song to end up in England on a Hootenanny project." I said, "Well, I guess the world really is getting a lot smaller." And you'll know what I'm talking about after we play this a little bit. It just really didn't fit that. But the guy says, big 4-CD set, and he sent me a few copies of it. And I thought, well, that's pretty cool, actually, for it to make it all the way across the pond and then back again, I guess. But this is called Iron Horse.
We still don't know what a Hootenanny is.
No, we
don't.
It's Hootenanny.
Now we know what Hootenanny is.
Now we know what it is. Just did. Okay, well, this next song is a song that Vance and Andy put together. They wrote it about a girl, and I don't know how that happened, but because that's a subject they know nothing about.
Show me a man who does.
Yeah, and that too. But it turned out to be a very interesting song. And it probably a lot of you ladies back could relate to this. And I guess they got in touch with their feminine side and blasted this thing out. It's called Mary's Not in Kansas.
For the first time today, down at the 6th Street dining room, this lucky girl in scared. But you don't know what to do, but she lives alone. And her friends are few. Daddy's farm had no charm when dreams get in the way. A restless soul is bound to wander. So she cut her strings and found her wings headed to a brighter day. Now that rainbow over yonder, you're very scared. But you don't know what to do, she lives alone. And her friends are few. Sometimes late at night when the moon shines through the window, loneliness is knocking at her door. She pulls the shade and cries, wonders if she'll make it. She wonders what she ever came here for. There's one thing for sure, Mary's not a Kansas anymore.
This next song would be what we would consider our signature song. It's gotten us to where we are today. It's a cover song, but you'll recognize it, Fire on the Mountain. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We appreciate y'all coming out tonight and being part of this. Because we didn't really know where Piedmont was. That's why we got so lost. So we had to kind of look it up and see where we were going. Sometimes we're bad to take off and not really know where we're going. We think we know where we're going, but as Ricky said, men sometimes think they know things they don't. And then we get lost. We'll do another tune for you. This one is just one that we like to do. We didn't write it, but we like to do it. It's called Dancing with the Angels.
There's a pathway in darkness, there's a pathway of light, and they meet at the old crossroads. The angels call me for spirit, we're a heart. All this will give me and we're alone. We'll be dancing, 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 dancing with the angels. Just like old Dagon Doe, let the light is in. The door will be open and everything spread out before you. Dancing with the angels.
YouTube video and I guess you would say a television station or whatever, but this song was on there. Fox News used it for bumper music, and it's been used in a couple of commercials and things like that. So we felt like we should probably do it for you while we're here. And you'll recognize the song. You've heard it probably most of your life. It's called Rocket Man.
She packed my bags last night pre-flight. 0 hours, 9 a.m. And I'm gonna be high as a kite by then. I miss the earth so much, I miss my wife. It's lonely out in space on such a timeless flight.
Group. I think they're based out of Montgomery, but there's a chapter in Los Angeles. And what they do is they go in there and they help families who have fell victim to violent crime. And this song was written about one of the people who was actually involved in that, a violent crime like that. And, so they sort of adopted this song. So it's called You'll Live On. You want to set up the archipelago?
We'll do this one without any music because we'll forget to play the music if we knew it. So. Oops.
TV, they'll never see this.
But on YouTube, you will.
What happened?
Did we get that harp sound blue?
You want to get your bow?
I'll take that. Thank you.
Oh, magic TV.
Go buy you a blue chip pick. That's what we recommend. They're brown.
They're UPS
on blue chip.
Do you have any samples?
Yeah. He knows
what I am too. I know.
And we are also sponsored by a company called Clear Voice. If our voice is cracked, it's no reflection on this product. And last but not least, check us out on our website at ironhorsebluegrass.com. Have some samples on there. You can order product. We do have product with us. If you're interested in leaving with an Iron Horse CD, we'd love to send you home with one. Anything else, guys?
You covered it.
You got it all.
Thanks to Duggar Mount for having us. We appreciate y'all having us.
Thank you very much for the work you're doing here.
So Clear Voice just got free advertising on APT.
Wake up, old sinner, you're facing the darkness of death. Each moment might be the moment you take your last breath. Is down on your
Would you stand with me, please? Heavenly Father, we're so grateful for this evening. Lord, we've been told in advance, and their families, we just thank you for the gifts you've given them and allowing us to share this time of mind with you. Father, we thank you for these dear people that have come here, and we thank you for safe travel as we leave. And Father, we trust that you'll continue to show us the way, that this ministry, this music hall, will become all that you desire for it to be. You know, we're moving so many ways into the unknown, but we thank you, we're not going alone. We love you, and we'll glorify you, Lord, with the days we have left, and share the incredible hope we find in you. We love you, Jesus, and we just thank you again. Amen.
Amen.
Another big hand for Iron Horse Bluegrass.
Thank you.